Good afternoon, dear students. Welcome once again. We are in the session of GK, Chapter 4, Mountain Ranges. So let's get clarified. Let's be clear with some of the facts of mountain. Which mountain lies in which region? Okay. So here in fill in the blanks, you have to fill in the blanks with the appropriate word. Dash is the highest. Peak of Mizoram. The highest peak of Mizoram is Phuong Kui. Okay, Phuong Kui is the highest peak of Mizoram. You note it down, or else if you can't able to see it clearly, I am going to provide you PDF also for it. But for the time being, you note it down. So Phuong Kui is the highest peak of Mizoram. Phuong, Phuong Kui. Okay, Phuong Kui. Coming on to the next question, the Lushai Hills are a part of the Dash Range. It is Patkai Range. P-A-T-K-A-I, Patkai Range. So these Lushai Hills are part of Patkai Range. The name of the range, the range, name of the mountains, ranges are Patkai. Okay. Another question is, Dash is a mountain range in Madhya Pradesh which forms the eastern base of triangular Satpura region. Satpura, Madhya Pradesh, yes. So the triangular form of Satpura range found in Madhya Pradesh is which mountain range? Michael range, M-A-I-K-A-L, Michael range. So it is the Michael range which forms the eastern base of what? Triangular Satpura range. Okay, this is the mountain range in Madhya Pradesh, Michael range. Okay, another question is number 4, the Dash range has the Mahadev Hills to the north. This mountain range has Mahadev Hills to the north and the Raj Pipla Hills to the west. That means in the north there is Mahadev Hills and to the west it is Raj Pipla Hills. It is Satpura Range, S-A-T-P-U-R-A, Satpura Range. It is very clear, Satpura Range. Okay, clear? Yes. Number 5, Doda Betta in the Dash Hills is the highest point in Tamil Nadu. The highest point in Tamil Nadu is Nilgiri Hills, very famous hill, right? Nilgiri Hills are the hills which forms the highest point in Tamil Nadu. Moreover, Doda Betta mountain also lies in that range. Okay. Coming on to the next question, the highest peak of the Western Ghats is located in Dash. In Western Ghats, the highest peak is located in Kerala. Those region which forms the hills of Western Ghat, right? The region near about to Maharashtra and Kerala. Take Kerala and Maharashtra, Western Ghat region. Okay. The highest mountain in that area is located in Kerala. Okay, clear? Yes. Now, the Guru Shikhar is the highest peak of Aravali Range. Name the highest peak of Aravali Range. The highest peak of Aravali Range is Guru Shikhar. If you can't able to see from here, you can note it from the down also. Maikal Range, Patkai, Phuong Kui, Guru Shikhar, Nilgiri, Satpura, everybody is given. So if you have any doubt, you can confer it from the down also, right? And Mount Godwin Austen, very famous mountain, is also known as Dash. What is the another name of Mount Godwin Austen? K2, yes, Karakoram Range. K2 is the name. So it is K2, Karakoram Range. Mount Godwin Austen is also known as K2. Clear? Yes. Right. So you have to fill these blanks by looking into the words which are given below, right? These are the words. From here you can take the word. From here I don't think it is clearly visible, but it is visible to some extent. Okay? Yes. Note it down fast. After that we will proceed on with the next chapter. Chapter number 5th. Right? Yes. If you have problem, I am going to provide you in the PDF also. Okay? Clear? Now, coming on to the 5th chapter, which is your History of India. Very famous chapter it is, History of India, where we have to learn the history, right? Now the first question, the Fort William, named after King William III. This Fort William is named after King William III of England, is located in which city? In which city this Fort William is located? In Kolkata. It is, there is a tick mark over here. You also put a tick mark in this box. Okay, don't put it like this. I have done it so that you can see it clearly. Don't get confused whether this one is for this box. This box belongs to this part or that part. Okay, so Kolkata is the right answer. Put a tick mark in the appropriate box, the box which is given in the right hand side. Okay, so Fort William, named after King William III of England, is located in Kolkata. Okay. Another question, number 2 question. The Viceroy of which country built the first European fort in India? The Viceroy of which country? Which country's Viceroy built the first European fort in India? It was Portugal. Okay, your 4 options given are France, Portugal, Britain and Germany. Out of these 4, the Viceroy of Portugal country built the first European fort. The first European fort is built by Portugal. Okay, Portugal Viceroy. Who was the first Viceroy of India? The first Viceroy of India was, first Viceroy was Charles Canning, the first Viceroy of India. Okay, put the tick mark in that. Clear? Yes. I think everybody able to see the things very clearly now. Okay? Charles Canning was the first Viceroy of India. Okay? Another question. In which year was the Indian National Congress formed? In which year was the Indian National Congress formed? In the year 1885. Okay? Yes. Fifth, whom did Muhammad Ghori defeated in the second battle of Terrain? So the Muhammad Ghori defeated in the second battle of Terrain. Whom he defeated? Prithviraj Chauhan. Okay? Yes. Now, who devised the doctrine of lakhs? It was Lord Dalhousie. Right? Which was the second ruling dynasty of Delhi Sultanate? Khalji dynasty, you know it now, right? Yes. The original name of which of these rulers was Farid Khan? Your options are Babur, Iltutmish, Sher Shah Suri and Maharana Pratap. It was Sher Shah, whose original name was Farid Khan, right? Farid Khan of Delhi. Okay. So these are the famous questions from history. Okay, clear? Okay? Yes. Note it down fast. Do it fast. I don't think it will take time. Let's proceed on with the next chapter. नंबर सिक्स चैप्टर कंप्राइजिंग ऑफ योर टेनिस स्टार्स ऑफ टुडे. ओनली यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई दीज फेमस टेनिस स्टार. ओके, द फर्स्ट पिक्चर यू सी इट वेरी क्लियरली एंड यू टेक द नेम फ्रॉम हेयर ऑल्सो सो दैट यू वोंट गेट कंफ्यूज. दिस वेरी फेमस पर्सनैलिटी इज जो विल्फ्रेड सोंगा. ही विल बी साइलेंट ओवर हेयर. सो यू टेक द नेम फ्रॉम हेयर जो विल्फ्रेड सोंगा. TSONGA. ही इज जो विल्फ्रेड सोंगा. दीज आर वेरी फेमस टेनिस प्लेयर्स ऑफ देयर कंट्री. ओके, वेरी फेमस टेनिस प्लेयर्स हु वेर फेमस वर्ल्ड वाइड. सो इट इज जो विल्फ्रेड सोंगा. एवरीवन नोट इट डाउन, जो विल्फ्रेड सोंगा. यस. ओके, अनदर पिक्चर कमिंग टू योर वे. लुक, ही इज वेरी फेमस टेनिस प्लेयर एंडी मरे. यू माइट बी हर्ड हिज नेम. दोस हु आर इंटरेस्टेड इन नॉन टेनिस, दे नो हिज नेम. एंडी मरे, वेरी फेमस प्लेयर. हिज सर्विस एंड हिज डिफेंस वाज एक्सीलेंट. ओके, एंडी मरे. आई हैव आल्सो सीन हिज प्ले. Andy Murray. He is Andy Murray. Okay? Andy Murray was a very famous player. Okay? You, if it is clear from here, is it okay? Otherwise, you choose it from blue box, which is given at the top. I don't think there will be any problem. Andy Murray. Okay? Now, a lady is coming. Okay? What is the name of this lady? Very famous tennis player. Simona Halep. Simona Halep. Simona Halep is the name of this very famous tennis player. Everyone look at your books. And whenever I am teaching you GK, you always sit with your books so that there will be no confusion. Okay? Yes. Simona Halep was there. Everyone noted it down? Yes. Good. Simona Halep. Now another picture coming to your way. Juan Martin del Potro. Okay? He is Juan, J-U-A-N, Martin, M-A-R-T-I-N, del, D-E-L, Potro, P-O-T-R, Potro. Juan Martin del Potro is the name of this very famous player. He was also very famous tennis player. Okay? Juan Martin del Potro. These days he is also playing. Okay? Juan Martin del Potro. Clear? Yes. Note it down fast. Okay? Yes. I think this is all of this page. I think you might have noted it down altogether, right? Yes. Now coming on to the next page, which comprises of the same, different players are there. Okay, everybody knows about this player, this very famous player, this tennis player, lady Carolina Wozniacki. Okay, Carolina Wozniacki. If you are watching the lawn tennis and if you are interested in lawn tennis, you might have seen her playing. Carolina Wozniacki, very famous player, top seeded, right? Carolina Wozniacki. Another very famous name coming on to your way, another lady who is equally famous, Angelique Kerber. Try to sit on the internet and whatever player's name is over here, 8 to 10 players, you can see different pictures of those tennis players so that you will able to identify those tennis player if that face is being given. Okay? Yes. Try to search out for different poses, different faces of those tennis players. Okay? Angelique Kerber is there. A-N-G-E-L-I-Q-U-E-K-E-R-B-E-R. Kerber. Angelique Kerber is there. Okay? Yes. Now another player coming to your way. He was Stanislas Wawrinka. You might also have seen him playing, right? Stanislas Wawrinka. Stanislas is S-T-A-N-I-S-L-A-S. Stanislas Wawrinka. W-A-W-R-I-N-K-A. Stanislas Wawrinka is the player. He is also good player of tennis. Men tennis player. Okay, Stanislas Wawrinka. Right?
Yes.
Now shall we go further?
Yes.
Another famous player is coming. Agnieszka Radwanska. Okay? Very famous she is. Agnieszka Radwanska. The spelling is A-G-N-I. Agnieszka. Agnieszka Radwanska. R-A-D-W-A-N-S-K-A. Radwanska. R-A-D-W-A-N-S-K-A. Agnieszka Radwanska. So these are the famous tennis players. These days also you can find them playing. Okay, these are recent tennis players. Now in the, if you have any problem with the spelling, go to the blue box and check it once. The spellings, no problem. Now one famous, this thing has given a fact that at the US Open 2018, Naomi Osaka, the name of the player, was the first Japanese to win the Grand Slam singles tournament after defeating Serena Williams in the final. So she became the first Japanese to take away the title, the first Japanese to win a Grand Slam in the history, Naomi Osaka. And whom she has beaten? She has beaten Serena Williams. Okay? Yes. Now, coming on to the next chapter. Chapter number 8, I think we have done, okay, or we are discussing, okay. So leave that one, come to chapter, subject verb agreement, chapter number 9, in which you have to put a tick mark in the right option, that's it, okay. So these are verbs, and you have to fill the blanks with correct form of verbs, okay. So everyone in the new team dash really hard to win the matches. So everyone in the new team tries really hard to win the matches. It is not tries, it's tries. Okay? That will be the correct form of verb that is suitable over there. Everyone in the new team tries really hard to win the matches. Okay? Yes. Neither Varun nor Khalid dash going for the conference. Neither Varun nor Khalid. Here two person are there, but because there is use of neither and nor, is the correct form of verb over here. Neither Varun nor Khalid is going for the conference. Okay. You don't put a tick. You have to fill these boxes. So fill in the box. Okay?
Yes.
Several ships dash at the port. Several ships arrived or arrives? It is arrived. Several ships arrived at the port. Okay? Some of the potatoes in the sack dash gone bad. Some of the potatoes in the sack have gone bad. It will be has, not has. Right? Yes, these things you should take care. Okay. Now Rohit and Bela dash their father to take care of the plants. Rohit and Bela helps their father or help their father? It will be help their father. Rohit and Bela help their father to take care of the plants. Okay, it's not helps their back father. It is help their father. Okay, yes. You write it down carefully without making any mistake in the spelling. Just over the mountain dash, the ruins of the historic village. Just over the mountain stands, okay? Just over the mountain stands the ruins of the historic village. Just over the mountain stands the ruins of the historic village. It will be stands, not stand, okay? You have to fill the correct form of verb. Right. The audience sitting in the auditorium cheering loudly or cheered loudly? The audience sitting in the auditorium cheered loudly. Okay. Because it is in past, so past is will be cheered. Cheering, that means the action is still going on. Because it is past, the audience sitting in the auditorium dash loudly. It has been reported. It is reporting. Okay. So in this you have to fill with cheered. Number 8. Here dash a list of things to be bought for the festivities. Here is a list of things. It is not here. Here is a list of things to be bought for the festivities. Yes? Yes. Rahul as well as his friend dash coming for dinner. Rahul as well as his friend is coming for dinner. Okay. Now last one. The cricket team dash in for a rude shop. The cricket team was in for a rude shop. You have to learn these things by heart. Okay, I don't think there will be any problem with this chapter. Right? Yes. Now, another chapter is vocabulary. Okay, in vocabulary you have to put on, you have to choose the correct word. There is a sentence. For that, which single word is appropriate, you have to choose. So, someone who is shy. Shy means? Yes, one who didn't open his mouth. That means very sharmila. In Hindi it is known as sharmila. Right? So someone who is shy and lacks confidence, who didn't have the confidence and who is shy, they are dauntless or diffident. They are diffident. Daunt means error. Okay? So they are diffident. So someone who is shy and lacks confidence are called diffident. If we need to define a student who is shy and lacks confidence, we say he is a diffident student, she is a diffident student. Okay? Yes? Yes. A tall and steep. Steep means narrow. A tall and steep rock face or cliff is known as gorge or precipice. It is precipice. Okay? Tall and steep, narrow rock face. That means face of a rock or cliff, top of the mountain. Okay? Is known as precipice. Okay? A person who is unfortunate. Person who is very unfortunate. Unfortunate means whose luck did not work. Okay. So the person who is very unfortunate is hapless or inauspicious.
They are hapless.
Okay. Hapless person or the person whose luck did not work. Okay. Number 4. Someone who can easily be convinced. Those person who are easily convinced. आराम से मना लेते हैं, समझा लेते हैं. To believe something, किसी चीज पर विश्वास करने के लिए. Those persons are called discerning or gullible.
They are gullible.
Okay, he is a very gullible guy. That means we can convince him for anything, for any facts. Okay,
they are gullible.
Okay. Another one, a conclusion based on unreasonable arguments. If a conclusion is based on unreasonable argument, it is fallacy. Okay. Unreasonable argument, that is false, fallacy. Number 6, something that is memorable. Memorable and unforgettable. Memorable and unforgettable. Indelible. In Hindi we used to say na avismaraniya ghatna. Avismaraniya, jo usko bhulaya na ja sake, right? So that is indelible, can't be deleted, indelible. Not revealing one's thoughts or feelings readily. It is reticular. Okay, not revealing one's thoughts. Whatever I am thinking, I don't expose it to you. That means not revealing the thoughts, they are reticular. Okay. To form an opinion from the information that you have. Suppose if you have an information and you form an opinion based on that. Okay. Or concur. C-U-N-C-U-R. Okay. Clear? I don't think there will be any problem with these words. If you want a greater explanation, go for these words in dictionary. Okay. Yes.
Yes.
Now note down your homework. Okay. Note down your homework. You have to learn chapter number 4, 5, 6 and 7. Okay. Next time in the GK class I am going to discuss further chapters. Till then have a nice day. Have a wonderful day. Bye.